I'm a US team leader and technical evaluation expert at MobiDev. Today I am going to tell you about software estimation. Who had an experience with software estimation? Please raise your hands as a developer, product owner. So good. I believe you know it's not so simple. And today I'm going to share with you our experience and approaches in that area. And you can compare it with your experience. In any case, I hope it might help you to save time and budget by launching product more efficiently. And for a good start, let me tell a story about one our project. Several years ago, we were approached by our potential client. He was in a restaurant business and owned a bar in San Francisco. And by then, he had realized that his current point of sale system doesn't fit with his needs. So he decided to look for an alternative, but didn't find nothing which fit well with his requirements. So he came up with the idea to build own point of sale and venue management system to install in his bar and deliver to other businesses, because the market no good solutions. That's how we started our collaboration. Of course, the client didn't want to spend money and time to recruit in-house software development team. Instead, he started looking for software development partner who would develop product while he concentrate on his business. And we started our discussion of basic requirements. We asked a lot of questions: how bar work, what he expect from the product, what he expect from software development process. We started analyzing risk and at the very beginning provided rough estimate, but even rough estimate helped us to understand that system could be implemented and we can move on. As for risk, we analyzed a lot of risk, and more interesting you can see here. No hardware was available at the very beginning. The recent printer didn't work well with Linux because there was some issues with drivers, and we had to use third-party device Linear Pro and its iOS SDK. And we will discuss this risk in details a little bit later. Keep on risk in mind and that fact that system should be provided to other businesses, so it should be easily configured to other instances, to other venues. We started with creating documentation and sketches. Functional and non-functional requirements sketches helped us to understand that we are on the same page with our client. And when we get entire system, we divided it into small blocks and estimated each block separately. After estimation, we find out that entire scope was estimated to take one calendar year, but implementation of whole scope wasn't reasonable at the very beginning, and customer needed system within 6 months to present it in an expo in Las Vegas. So we lived the least important features to the next version and increased amount of developers in our team. And only in this stage we signed a final contract. Before that stage we built customer for small blocks, for creating documentation, prototyping and so on. Over the next 6 months our team was working hard to provide product on time and on budget. And we attracted customer only in crucial occasion and for regular demos. When the product was ready, our team was invited to the expo to deploy, set up and present product in the best way possible. And at this expo were people who attended this event without a goal to buy new venue management system with point of sales, but they got acquainted with it and ordered a few instances to their bar. And now let us get closer look to each stage, and let me start with estimate. It's in our nature to believe that complex formulas like this always provide more precise results than simple approaches like this. Let's compare software estimation methods and find answer. regardless of soft estimation type for fixed cost development or agile development, we can create estimate using different methods. It can be formal estimation like COCOMO or analogy-based estimation. It can be expert estimation or combined estimation. If we talk about COCOMO, it's a parametric model which affects on input parameters a lot. And who sets these parameters? People. And people can make mistakes. Such kind of estimate little bit artificial. And analogy-based estimation works well when we need to create some very similar application. For example, it works great for white labels or WordPress websites or something like that. And expert estimation is my favorite approach because it provides the maximum precision. This kind of estimation helps us to analyze requirements in a very good way. We use work breakdown structure and separate requirements into small blocks. It helps us to understand what should be implemented. It allows to provide very precise estimation. If we return to our example, formal estimation didn't work well with this request because it was custom request and we used expert estimation for initial estimate. Also, we can use combined estimation, and it works great for some white label application with customized blocks. For example, we use it when we need to provide this system to another businesses. We estimate a major bulk of the product by analogy, because we have already provided to other businesses. And of course, every client wants some customization to its system, and we attract expert or group of experts who adjust this estimate. And when we create estimation, we always should be focused on restriction because every project has restriction on time or price. And anyway, we should take them into account. But estimate should be impartial. That's why we build processes where first initial estimate provided by experts and they don't know about this restriction. They provide their vision, how many it takes to implement this system. And if we understand that the whole scope is impossible to implement within 6 months, we will never say it. Instead, we offer viable option and let us get look what we can do if our estimate doesn't meet expectation by price. We can use small team. Of course, small team means less amount of time on communication. Developers shouldn't spend time on merging code in Git, agree on architecture, and so on and so on. We can start development after detailed elaboration of requirements. Modern projects usually starts when not all requirements are finalized because market is changes. And to save time, we can increase amount of additional work of elaboration requirements at the very beginning, but it slows things down. And front-end development could be started only after backend. In this way, it's very convenient to front-end backend front-end developers because they shouldn't substitute requests, create some mock objects, fake objects on front-end side. Backend, when the backend is ready, they create front-end using API documentation. It's very convenient way to save price, but it increases timeline. Also, we can reduce time and scope, reduce scope and simplify navigation and UI. Meaning no whistles and bells in the very beginning. It helps to save both time and price. And in our example, we had mismatches by time. Price was okay with our customer, but we should increase speed of development. And what we can typically do in such situation, we can involve additional developers. Of course, it's require additional time for communication, as I said, and merging code in Git and so on and so on. But developers can work simultaneously, so it decreases timeline of the product. It's possible to start early with a rough idea, basic idea, and not finalized requirements. But in our example, it was a custom request, and we didn't start early. We decided at the very beginning carefully elaborate all requirements and foresee risks. And this approach can work for some small projects. We can simultaneously start back-end and front-end development. And we elaborated the requirements carefully, like at the second approach. It's allowed us to start simultaneously, back-end and front-end, because we had documentation and we knew beforehand models on back-end and front-end. So we started simultaneously and decreased timeline of this project. And as I said, we can reduce scope and simplify navigation and UI. But we didn't simplify navigation and UI in these projects. And answer is simple. As I said, no whistles and bells, but this project required whistles and bells, because first version of the system did the same action as its rivals. Process requests, sell products and so on, but do it differently, more convenient, with better productivity, and to bring business to the next level. That's why we didn't simplify UI. And overtime is a very tricky thing. It shouldn't be used a lot, but sometimes if you need to implement some additional feature closer to release, it's inexpedient to involve new developers who don't know the project. Instead, it's better to use overtime a little bit, but be careful with it. What is important? The simpler requirements are defined, the simpler and less expensive they might be implemented. So, what is the problem? All we have to do just carefully elaborate requirements in this stage, isn't it?
Yes.
In real life, no. The market is changing so quickly, and as long as you finish your requirements fully, they might be already outdated, so we need to find balance. And we have a solution, MVP. MVP, it's a product created with minimal time and expenses, but it provides to user some set of features which brings value to them. For example, in real life, we must move from point A to point B, and kick scooter will make a good start. And later we can purchase better vehicles. And when we have estimate, I want to ask you a question. What do you prefer, underestimation or overestimation? Who think underestimation is better? Please raise your hands. Who think overestimation is better? Yes, you are totally right. But in perfect situation, golden mean, it's the best. Best estimate. So our goal to hit this point. And of course, you know, if we have overestimation, we have Parkinson's law, which says that work's job takes all time assigned to it. Worst thing to happen in this case, it's spend all time assigned to this project, improving project, fixing some bugs, polishing it, and so on. And in case of underestimation, we have a lot of bad things, like failed marketing campaigns, stopgap solutions, and so on and so on. And bad architecture renders product development almost impossible in future. What is important, we need to update estimate during the project, because we have one out of uncertainty, which shows that at the very beginning we have very high level of uncertainty, and we should update estimate during it progresses. And if you talk about estimates for agile development, we can start approximately at these stages, maybe at sketches, something like this. And if you talk about fixed price project, we can start only when requirements pretty defined. And more risky companies can start earlier. And let me combine these two different charts. We rotate cone of uncertainty by 90 degrees and combine it with previous one and receive this good picture. As you can see at the very beginning, we have not very precise estimate. It's just stage of basic idea. But as you can see, as the project progresses and cone of uncertainty narrows, we receive more precise estimate. And it narrows very fast. And approximately at the design stage, we have pretty precise estimate, which allows optimal budget planning. And closer to release, it becomes more and more close to point of absolute estimate precision. What is important, it's vital to keep risks in mind in every project. That's why our project managers create a risk management plan. And to know risk or to manage risk, we should know them. And we analyze what can be wrong during the project and arrange risks by probability and impact to receive a risk score, to find most dangerous and most probable risks, to manage them at the very beginning. Here you can see a few examples of risk. We divide them into internal and external risk. Internal risk comprise everything within software development company, and they are less dangerous by good, well-established process and software development company. It might be vacation or sick leaves, employees' departure, misunderstanding of requirements, and issues in initial estimation. But as I said, this risk might be easily managed in software development company. Most dangerous risks are here, external risk. It's usually some third-party devices, third-party libraries, SDKs, and so on and so on. But the role of software development companies is risk also very high. They should foresee them and manage them. In any case, fully avoid risk in the project are next to impossible. But risk management is vital for every project. If you talk about some small projects, maybe 1 or 2 months, it's a good idea to avoid risk. If you talk about big and long-term projects, it's risk management is vital. It helps to make business sustainable. And let's go back to our example. We had no hardware available at the very beginning. So we didn't wait until we received real point of sale devices. We knew device configuration beforehand and used PC with Linux at the very beginning. Of course, PC didn't have reset printer, touch screen, and credit card reader, but it was good enough for the start to work on architecture of the project. And when our client received first shipment of real devices, we received also a few instances to test on real devices. Second risk, reset printer didn't work well on Linux. So why we decided to use Linux? Because previous point of sales of our customer was working on Windows and it was not so good and he didn't want a Windows solution. And reset printers he had at that time didn't work well on Linux. That's why our expert analyzed this and helped him to find on the market a printer which will work well with this station and with Linux system. And third risk, we had to use third-party device Linear Pro and its iOS SDK. Its device something like Keys And you can swipe credit cards to make payments. And you know that update iOS, very simple. It's just few clicks on iPhone or iPod. And to avoid risk where users updates, it's for stuff in the bar. And to avoid risk where people update iOS when system doesn't test it to work with new iOS system, we find simple solution. After initial setup, just sign out from Apple ID in iOS settings. It solved the issue with unexpected updates. So we updated system only when we tested in, and we made sure that everything is okay. And what I can say, estimation is vital for every business because it allows budget planning and helps to make plans for future. It's very important to find balance between estimate and restriction, and restriction shouldn't affect on estimate. Estimate should be impartial, and MVP might help us to solve this problem. Also, it's very important to update estimate during the project because we have cone of uncertainty during the project. And keep risk in mind to save your business. And thank you for your attention. If you have any question, you can ask.